with the discussions about the future and the development of Jamaica's football picking up a head of steam, it is obvious that local football is searching for a new identity after more than two decades of the late captain being in full command of the ship. The impression is that there is a pushback against the emergence of another captain, with the other extreme of docile, almost invisible leadership now in place. But lest we forget, the captain has been our best, most accomplished, and most successful football leader ever, with his trademark strong, decisive, inspirational, and visionary leadership. And the football needs some of that kind of leadership right now. This bugger argument, for example, about a franchise system is a big waste of time and energy, and nothing will come of it anytime soon. The football leadership needs to be pragmatic and decisive in recognizing that and move forward. Jamaica is still a relatively small, relatively poor nation with relatively little or no football culture. We have to accept our imperfections and shortcomings and bite off where we can chew. We need to continue the quest for incremental improvements with our clubs and our leagues. We have to wholesomely and strategically embrace the selling of our young players on the open market. And crucial and connected to everything is the fortunes of our senior reggae boys team, which is the heart and soul of the entire football program. The marketing, the visibility and profile of our football brand, even the sellability of our players, depend on the success and the status of the Reggae Boys unit. Everything spin off of that. We have to prioritize smartly and do what we're doing with passion, pride and purpose, and stop clowning the football like it's a circus.